Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're in Luminor's Tower. Looks like we're about to head down. Even though it's a tower, you'd think we're going up. I inadvertently backed up and found a hidden wall with a switch there, which I have since depressed, which turned off a swinging blade going back and forth across the tunnel. Very interesting. Little traps and dungeons. I like it. So yeah, definitely looks like we're going down. As you enter the torture chamber, you are met with a blast of heat. The sound of boiling fills the room and the air reeks of sulfur. To the southwest, you see a large pool made of huge skulls in which lava is boiling. Suddenly, you notice the weak groaning sounds and cries for help from a distant part of the room. Behind an area closed off by iron bars, you see many starving, emaciated beings lying or crouching. Some of them appear to have seen you and try to pull themselves up using the iron bars. To the south, outside the cell, is a woman dressed in the clothing of a healer. These are the townspeople. As far as you can see, she is trying desperately to open the door of the cell. Okay, she's outside the door trying to open up the cell. Okay, so it's one huge cell which has all these people. Oh! Okay, we're in a different mode. Okay, so this is not a treasure chest. This is... wait a second. She's trying to open the cell? Not about her, she's inside the cell. And what are these? Are these people alive? Because they kind of look like skeletons. And is this a door out? I don't know. This is the... full of boiling stuff. Kind of looks like we can, step right into it, doesn't it? Doesn't seem to hurt at all, for some reason. Hello! You see before you a young woman wearing a white robe. Could that be Sabine? Let's poke her. Now let's talk to her. It is! Yay! We found her! Age 29, human, female, healer level 6. I hardly dared hope that help would come. The fire demon Luminor is holding all the inhabitants of Burnville as prisoners here in the torture chamber. Perhaps we should get together, for together we'd be better able to free the people. I saw that Luminor personally holds the key to the cells. Okay. Funny how they call the place Burnville, as if, like, okay. We are going to be burned in our future, let's call the place Burnville. As far as I know, he lives on one of the upper floors in the tower. Now, I didn't see any way up, but I guess it must be behind another hidden wall or something. Sandra! That's your mother. You know anything special about her? Do you know anything about the tower, no? Sphere of opening? I don't think so, yeah. If Father Anthony? I don't think he mentioned her. Burnville! Daughter? You are her daughter. Hello? Let's see if we can ask her about Luminor. I don't know what you are talking about. Alright, I'm just gonna invite you into our group. Let us go and find Luminor so that we can get the poor people out. Yay! New party member. And she comes with stuff. I love people who come with stuff. Who come with stuff? Yeah, I can talk. Okay, Gala's robe. A hat. Gala's club. Gives a shield plus 10. What if we identify if it had any more properties? Damage plus 15 on the club. Okay, so you got sling stones and a stone sling. Spell points 5, 3 of them. 6 healing potions 4. 3 cure poison flasks. 6 revitalizing flasks and a holy horn. Now we've had a holy horn before. It banishes undead, I believe. Dispel undead. Alright, so most likely also has spell undead. A certain amount of charges. That one has 14, that one has 11. I don't know how many charges hers has, but in any case, it's fine. We're getting a nice collection of holy horns now. And she's also got leather shoes. How are her stats? 45 out of 50 strength, 47 out of 50 intelligence, all out of 50 dex, 39 speed, 49 stamina, 34 charisma, 41 luck, 19 and avoid magic, I think that is, or magic resistance 10, I believe that is. Attack 43 out of 25, that's helped with her club there. Parry 20%, swim 90%, I'm impressed with that. Zeros for a lot of this stuff. 61% read magic, better than me, and 86% use magic, pretty good. She has 20 training points to use. Only 4 spell learning points, so she's not going to be learning any new spells for a while. We can also check what spells she has. She also comes with her own gold and some rations. Pretty nice. And by joining our group, she's automatically added into the magical shield and magic weapon spells. So if I select... May Gala assist us on our mission. Indeed. So if I go like this, she has Healing Hand, Remove Shadows, Remove Pain, Small Healing, Remove Poison, and Medium Healing. And also Destroy Undead and Remove Fear while combat is in place. Alright, that's good. We've got a healer, that's what we wanted. And she has a full mana bar. I like it. A metal plate is fitted between the iron bars in the cell door. It depicts the face of a demon surrounded by tongues of flame. Well. Doesn't fit the door. Yeah, Luminor has the key, she said, so I don't think we're going to be able to pick it. Just can't pick it, I tell ya. Can I reach? No, I can't actually see these people unless they go right up to the bars here. No. I don't want to wait. I can almost see you. I don't think she comes up to the bars. These people look very close to the bars. But I don't think I can reach them now. A badly injured prisoner looks at you beseechingly and says, "Please, noble adventurers, help us in our misery." Are you asking me to help you be miserable? Same. Okay. Can't reach these people. If I could, I imagine they'd say the same. Oh wait, I can reach her. Oh. Shouldn't say anything else. Are these people alive? Who do you want to talk to? I don't know what she would say. Nothing new. Alright. Kind of looks like a way out over here. Yeah, I don't think these people are actually alive. Alright. Well, we found Sabine, and that's awesome. So that's a door there. So that's where we came in, right? Oh, there's a door over here that we missed. Maybe that goes up. Or does that go out? I think that... No, that goes out. Never mind. Did I save after finding her? Oh, our protections are gone? Ah. I'm gonna try to make do without them because it uses all my mana just to put them on. Not sure exactly how useful they are. I'm saving that. Another trap. I'm trying to back up again. Ah, look at that. Same thing. As the train presses the button, the squeaking of the pendulum outside in the corridor suddenly stops. Sweet. So this goes up. Floor number two. And we go up again. There's no trap here. I find that very unlikely. just in case. Okay. Darkness. Torch didn't actually help that much. Judging by the dust covering this floor, no one has been in this part of the tower for a very, very long time. So is this Luminor undead then? This door here. Because how could he live up on the top part of the tower? That goes up even more. So Sabine is level 6. The others are 8, 10, and I'm 15. So she's a little behind us. Hope she doesn't get slaughtered by whatever we're facing. In the wooden door, there's a round opening surrounded by runes. The runes say something the something, I believe that is. Alright, hold on 1 second. Time to get my runes going. Hold on 1 moment. Trying to shrink this down a little bit. Okay. It's one of my least favorite parts of these games, Amberstar and Ambermoon. So we've got U. S. Okay, let's use the something, right? Because then. T-H-E. Use the S something H. Is it this? S D A. I don't think so. No, that's the opposite way. The bad thing is these don't exactly match what you see on the screen. They need to be more pixelated, more blocky. But it does look kind of like this P here. The F faces the other way. But this is an S, isn't it? And this is an S. So S sphere. Okay. I was like, what's SPH? I was doubting it and wasn't going further, so the H is an E. E something E, and then this is H is. Actually, R is, this. Use the sphere, it says. Okay. We'll use the sphere. Nelvin has unlocked the door. I mean, I would have tried that anyway. What's with the floor? I mean, ceiling. Okay, that's just a statue. Oh, the ceiling's back. Okay. We can't talk to these. That's a teleporter thingy. Or you know what? I think this might be raising your attributes. Yeah, the teleporter doesn't look like that. This raises someone's attributes, so in order to use this effectively, we use the very unrealistic method of seeing what it does and then going back in time to use it on who might need it most. Okay, so let's take a quick... survey of my stats. I am 55, 33, 34, 21. Goes through the other door, you might find another one. 55, 33, 34, 21, 50, 100. Unfortunately, doesn't tell you what it's raising. At least last time it didn't. And then my skills are 80%, 25, 100, because I have the Sobek ring. 0000 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 73 45. Alright, let's see what might happen. I am the selected one. A strange light hovers in the air ahead of you. Should Citrine reach for it? Yes. As Citrine touches the light, it seems to be absorbed by her body. Okay, absorbed. Absorbed and helping what? 55, 33, 34, 21, 50, 100, 16, 5. Nothing there. 80, 25, 100, 0, 73, 40. Use magic went up by 3. Good, I needed that. I did need that. I am the least of the magic users that has that. So I'm going to change this. 48, you know what? I'm wondering if it's random too. See, so he has 86 and he has 100, so it's me that's struggling to cast these spells over and over again. I'm curious if I go back in if it's 40 still up by just 3%, or if it's gonna be it's random. Normally I wouldn't even do this. I'm just really curious if it's a random effect. Random amount, rather. Let's see if it's the same. 50 now. I'm not sure if I can go past 50. So I'm going to change this to 50. Because... just want to check really quick, make sure nothing else went up. No. 55, 33, 34, 21, 50, 100, 16, and 5. Okay. So I'm now 50. I might not be able to... I may or may not be able to go past that with this thing, but I'm gonna stop here and just enjoy the increase. I'm saving the 65. Okay, quite a few doors, and then this is the stairs up, I believe. Let me just make sure there's no hidden walls here, like secret walls, secret doors. Okay, seems legit anyway. Okay, coming out, there's a door. Didn't mean to do that. There's a door ahead of us. Let's hit the door ahead of us then. We have another one. I know it's kind of cheesy because it's just saved. But this will help us easily get back to where we were. As Citrine reaches for the light, it dissolves with her body. The other one said it was absorbed, didn't it? Okay, so let's see if anything changed here. 55, 33, 34, 21, 50, 100, 16, 5, nothing there. 80, 25, 100, 0, 0, 0, 0. Read magic is now unlimited out of 50. 100 out of 50. Not complaining. Read magic. And his is 54. Mine couldn't be over 50, so that helps me a lot. His can go up to 99 through normal means. Mine could only go to 50, so. And hers is already 61, so this is all for me. Thank you very much. So far, this is all for me. Now I don't have to worry about failing scrolls. Gonna check the walls, see if there's anything secret. There's a funky song. Oh, there's another door out of here. Look at that. Alright, let's go through this. Another attribute increasing thingy. Pulsing light, or whatever they're calling it. Can I walk past that? Yeah. Alright, so this is obviously intended to help us with the battle ahead. And I do appreciate that, but on the other hand, I'm gonna wonder how hard this battle's gonna be. Okay, so I need to change this for... I didn't alter this. So my use magic is 50, and my read magic is now 100. Alright, so let's see what this does. When the light sphere is touched, it disappears into the body of Citrine. Every time the text is a little different. That's pretty cool. It's attention to detail, you know, changing things up a little. Alright, so... I don't know, it's been changing attributes. 80, 25, 100... Zeros... 150, that doesn't change. 55, 33, 34, 21... 50, 100, 16, and 5. It might have increased something that I'm already maxed out in, like charisma or read magic or swim. Or something that I can't go past for whatever reason. There, so I'm just checking it again. They seem to be... The others helped magic. Alright, let's... Let's try it with agile. Maybe it's helping swimming, so... 35, 36... 50... 44, 40, 16, 21, and 0. And then the skills are 95, 36, 5, 4 zeros, 7, 0, and 0. Let's see if this helps with anything for him. So we have to load. And then have him chosen. Disappears into the body of Edgel. So the skills 95, 36, 5. 7, 0, 0, didn't change anything there. 55, 36, 50, 44, 40, 16, 20. 55, 36, 50. 40, 16, 21, 0. Nothing changed here, unless it affected something like his training points or his experience. Look at that, 8888. Do we have that? I wish it told you what changed. Okay. I already knew he was 10. He was a level 10. 129 life points, 12 training points, 1520. I don't know if I'm gonna remember that. Maybe it's changing one of those. Okay, so 129, 12, 15, and 20. Let's see. Bear with me, guys. I'm trying to see what this changes, and I can't seem to be able to figure that out. I mean, maybe it would only help one party member. I don't see anything changing. I'm gonna try one more person. Sabine. Now it's gonna look at attributes and skills. 45, 47. I'm actually curious. Well, he has the same experience points, same level. I'll just try with her. If I can't see any change, she'll keep that. Just looking, 46, 106. Spell learning points 4, training points 60, attack defense 15, 13. Alright, let's see if anything changes. I know I'm spending a lot of time on this, but it's important. This is permanent. At least it should be.